area, we're just going to drive around. It's Anne Hathaway's family home. Now, the reason that they still refer to her as Anne Hathaway instead of potentially, you know, Shakespeare, and is because Shakespeare's mother's name was also Anne. So they've been always been able to differentiate. Now, Anne Hathaway's family home, it's absolutely beautiful, very picturesque area, beautiful thatched roof. So hence why we always make sure we come out to get the photo opportunity. Plus, it's not in walking distance from Shakespeare's house. Yeah, we'll go nice and slow. So photo opportunity for those on the left. Then we're just going to turn around in the car park, and then so those of you on the right will also get a nice clear photo. So Anne Hathaway's house and garden is on the left hand side. Okay, so now it's just a couple of minutes from here into the town centre. Now, as we're going to drive along, we'll do a driving orientation for you down the, essentially the one main street, and then the other main street is pedestrianised anyway. So as we're going in and turning down the main street, I'm going to firstly point out the steeple in the distance of the church that Shakespeare is buried in, and the family. So I'll show you how to make your way back down there should you wish to go and see that inside the church. Then of course we'll point out a couple of lunch spots and a few of the other Shakespeare houses. And then where we drop off is exactly where we'll pick up. And then if anyone just wants to walk down to Shakespeare's house, I'm just going to walk down to that part of the main road, and I can point people in any direction from there that you may like to go. Okay, are we ready?
Yes.
Ready to keep your eyes peeled for the steeple I'm about to point out?
Yes.
Again, Stratford-upon-Avon has those same sort of signs that point to the main sites around the city. So for orientation purposes, they come in quite handy when you're going to and from the church. So we're going to be turning left, but if you cast your eyes right and look through the trees, you should be able to catch a glimpse of a steeple. Can you see that?
Yeah.
Okay, so it's just straight down this road here to get to the church. And then you can either walk up the river's edge or along this street again to get you back up to where the coach is. So this is one of the main streets along here. You'll see they've got a number of different buildings that again have the date back to the time of Shakespeare. They've really looked after it. Here on the right hand side, this was also one of the old schools. And all of these old buildings have big plaques on them as well that tell you more about the history. And oh, it's open, you can go into it. Shakespeare's schoolroom and Guild Hall. You've got the new house on the right hand side, which was Shakespeare's, next to it was Shakespeare's new house for his adult life. You've got the Macquarie of Stratford-upon-Avon there on the right hand side, on the honeymoon suite door. It says much ado about nothing. Now up here, there is my little hidden treasure, the Garrick Inn pub, directly to our left-hand side now. Now in there, if you're looking for something just to grab something to eat, it can be quite busy, but it's worth going in there for a look. Dating back to the time of Shakespeare, it's just a really nice on the interior. So, and it's free to walk into, to check out. So
there's
doing that. And a few of your main high street shops if anyone's after bits and pieces. At this roundabout, on a few of the corners, is cash machines. Some of you asking for an ATM. We are going to be walking up to Shakespeare's house on the left-hand side, that street there that curves up to the left. We're going to drive around to the top of that to drop off. So if you walked all the way down, then you'd come to this roundabout and you can make your way down the main road. Also, just further down to the right-hand side was also the River Avon. Get a glimpse into the gardens, just here on the left-hand side. Oh, look, the performers are out there in the back left corner there. The Shakespeare shop. If anyone is very much a Shakespeare fan, definitely have a look in the Shakespeare shop. They've got some really nice...
So we are at Stratford upon Avon. This is the home of Shakespeare. And this is... do we need to be down this street or the one this runs into it? The Wizards? I wonder what that is. The Enchanting? Maybe. Looks like they have some souvenir shops. There's the Shakespeare Center.
Yeah, if you go down here in the
Kevin and I had already picked out where we wanted to eat. And there's a Peter Rabbit shop. There's a Patisserie Valerie.
Yeah, they're over.
Yeah, but if you don't want to spend the money, we don't have to. So as you can tell, we're walking down right down the middle of the street because this isn't for cars. There's a the Nutcracker Christmas shop.
See the Christmas shop?
Yeah. Oh, no, thank you. There's lots of gift shops. There, it says public library on the top of it. Huh? Oh wow. What is that? It still amazes me that people sit outside in the cold and eat. You just don't do that at home.
Some people sound better than others.
Yes, absolutely. W.H. Smith, but it looks like a book. That looks like a bookstore.
We have
a Vodafone.
There's Jeffers Place.
There's Debenhams. Yay for Debenhams.
Jeffers Steak.
There's a Starbucks. Wonder if there's a special mug.
For this place.
With like Shakespeare on it or something. I remember passing this.
Yeah, we drove by. Because I love the building.
Oh, I see it. You'll have to take a picture when we get down here. There's a Lush store. Robert Diaz. So today we plan to have lunch at the Hathaway Tea Rooms, and hopefully there's plenty of room for us. This is the Shakespeare gift shop, so I guess everything in here will be Shakespeare.
This is the one issue, apart from football, that completely divides the British. Milk in first or after? And again, you know, tea being so important. So to give you an example just of how important tea is to how hot this topic is of milk in first or after. In the World War II, they actually had a man in charge of putting together an emergency distribution plan in case the factories that produced the tea bags were bombed. Thank you. As we're crossing out to the left, you can not just see Houses of Parliament. We've also got Lambeth Palace to the front left on the corner. And you have also got, of course, the London Eye directly to our left. Now, as you know, London Eye is right near the London Reception Centre, so we are just a couple of minutes away.
No, we're back in London. I don't know, the last showed us coming into London. There was a lot of footage coming into London. So these flags weren't out last week when we were here. So we're walking up to Trafalgar Square, and the reason we're doing that on our last night is because every time Kevin and I came by here, they had the stuff out for the opera. And even, twice. Even when,
actually three times.
Yeah, when Jennifer, Nathan, and Luke, and all of us, okay, and Stefan, even when all of us walked up through here, it's always been covered. So I'm gonna try to get it tonight, some good pictures.
Technically, we could have went.
I wonder why all those rifles are out there.
I hope so.
I know, I wonder why they're all out there over there.
It's with a horse.
Of course, I'm completely and totally blurry. Like, literally, now I'm not, but I was. When I was zoomed in on those horses, there's that, the ghost bus tour. Right there. Okay, we are in Trafalgar Square. Kevin took a picture of me in front of one of the lions. There's lots of people that are climbed up here, but you have to, it's quite a big step from this side anyway, and maybe it's easier from another side, but I think this fountain maybe was always closed off.
We never walked on this part.
Yeah, so Kevin, we'll have to, let's take a picture over here.
You gotta take a
look. Yes, you do. Yeah. So we went in the National Portrait Gallery, and we just cut through because you probably can't hear me. Because we needed to make a few last minute purchases. So now we're gonna try to, are we going back down here?
No, we're
gonna try to make our way back down to Big Ben. This is these are Whitehall Gardens, and it's really pretty. I think we passed here in the car, and I might have gotten a video from it in the car. There is. Yeah, we passed it in the car, and I've had video of it, but we've never been in here, and I bet you anything it looks, I bet it's busy during the day, because it looks like it would be a peaceful place to come and sit and have your lunch. This tree's in such bad shape that they have put supports on it. Like little crutches. And across the way there is the Lanai. This is a beautiful building. That's what I just said. It is beautiful. How are we doing on time? Yeah, I love this building. This part right here, for some reason, reminds me of the Haunted Tower Hotel because it has the arches and it's way up in the air. The one at Walt Disney World, if you don't know what I'm talking about, it's the one that takes you up in an elevator and drops you down. Yeah, it does. It does. So I want to hear Big Ben one more time, like in its full glory, because they said it's going to be out of commission for how long? Like 3 years?
3 or 5 years.
So I want to make sure I hear it one more time really well before we leave. So we're going to stand right here on this street corner. And yep, we have 4 minutes. And we're just going to stake our claim on this pole. There's a pole right behind me.
Take too long.
What do you think about what I have in my view? We are right now. Did you get it? Is that the? I thought the whole top of it fit in there.
Really close. I can't get that. I'm not walking in front.
Are you not allowed to walk in it? I think you can. Can't you? Do it quickly. Just do it. What are they gonna take it off the grass? Just do it. Okay, Kevin's doing probably something he's not supposed to. He's going up here for a picture. I want to tell you where we're at. The London Eye is over here, and this is like our hotel. We've walked across the street, and the hospital is actually over here. But there is a park right here in front of the hospital, and I've seen pictures from this vantage on Instagram, and you can see Big Ben through the statue. Also, if you go down this way, you can get more pictures, like down here, yeah. Down these steps. You can get pictures down there of Big Ben. And I showed you that earlier in the week, like way earlier in the week before we went to Scotland. But this is a different vantage that Kevin saw pictures of. And so he wanted to get it from here. And I think he's going to try to get it with some roses in front of it too.
That's cool. See that little bend right there?
Yeah.
I got the clock sitting on that bend.
Oh, that's neat. So, like, I'll show you where he's at. He's, like, taking a picture, like, right through there of the statue. So, I'll show you those when they'll be at the end of this video. So, we're going to get a couple more the flowers. These people are up here taking pictures. We've been told that they're not really, usually it's not really a wedding party. That usually it's just people wanting to get pictures for a magazine. So we'll get ours really quick and move on. So before we go back to the room for the night, we wanted to come out here for one last time because we went and we said goodbye to Big Ben. Now we have to say goodbye to the eye.
Can I put it up for a second?
And they haven't lit it up yet, but usually when we were in our room, it took them a while. What do you mean?
Right there, all those red and orange.
Oh, to get, those are for fast track tickets.
Yeah,
when we were in our room, it took them a while to light it up too. So they'll probably wait until about 8 o'clock, I would think. And it's, what is it, quarter till eight now? Quarter till seven. Oh, wow. That's earlier than I thought.
It's actually 20 till five.
I just pointed out the shard to Kevin because he loves when they're covered, when things are covered with like a fog and clouds.
I think it's cool.
And so I pointed this out to him. Because the top of that is cool. Can you imagine being up in that right now? You wouldn't get to see much.
No, I can't imagine being up in that period.
So the London Eye is right there. And we're walking down here. We've never walked down this far. And not down through here. And this is the building that we walked through the park earlier. This one right here, where we showed you the statues and the tree that was propped up. That looks like bowling pins. So there's a park right over here for kids. Yeah, they're putting something together here. I smell like cinnamon. I smell... Well, it smells good. It smells very cinnamony. I wonder what that entrance is down there. That stone?
We're up carousel.
Yeah. There's a frozen yogurt down here. Yeah.
Bouncy house?
I think.
No, that's a show. What's
that? Oh, is it?
One of those stages.
You know, they said come down here and have something to eat, but then again, when it's too cold, I don't think so. I think when it's too cold, they don't do it. I think, you know what, there are places to eat down through here, but it's so cold.
Yeah. You ready to go back? Here's a train.
And you can hear a train coming. Or is it on the other side? It must be on the other side. There's a train on the other side. Yeah, you can't see it.